Noi ci occupiamo della messa a punto e applicazioni di metodi per determinare.
We study the development and applications of methods for determining substances of any origin in the biomedical field, in the environmental and toxicological field, even cultural heritage. We have created a series of methodologies, which we are developing with new materials, nanotechnologies, and new principles to determine substances in a way that is fast, simple, and highly sensitive. Today, we're used to sensors being everywhere. They measure our heart rate, track how many steps we take, all physical parameters. We can measure blood pressure, temperature. This is a fact. Biosensors are totally different. We have to measure something chemical through molecular recognition by a substance, by an antibody. This is the hard part to achieve and to turn into something that can enter the market.
Il nostro lavoro di chimici analitici è sempre molto applicativo, volto alla ricerca.
Our work as analytical chemists is always very practical. We search for solutions that provide information and tools that make analysis possible even in situations where a clinical laboratory isn't available.
Anche a casa per monitorare il proprio stato di salute o nell'ambulatorio del proprio medico.
Even at home for monitoring your own health or at the doctor's office. Or when we need immediate results for emergencies, like in an ambulance or the emergency room, or in developing countries, or in cases of isolated communities like research stations in Antarctica.
Avere i sistemi pronti nel point of need.
In other words, to have systems ready for use at the point of need. When a diabetic has to measure insulin, he has to take a blood sample, which is still an invasive procedure, even if it is just the pinprick of a needle. Instead, for the future, we must find methods for analyzing other fluids, like saliva and sweat.
For a ride into orbit, NASA astronaut Randy Breznik, Sergey Rozhansky of Roscosmos, and Paolo Nespoli of the European Space Agency launched at the end of last week from the Baikonur Cosmodrome.
La collaborazione con la NASA e con l'Agenzia Spaziale Europea.
Our work with NASA and the European Space Agency began about 10 years ago when we participated in the first project simulating a mission to Mars called Mars 500 because it takes 500 days to go and come back from Mars.
On the 3rd of June 2010, while most of us were planning our summer holidays, six men were getting ready for a very different experience. 520 days of isolation in space.
E su queste sei persone noi abbiamo potuto effettuare una serie di esperimenti e sviluppare.
We conducted a series of experiments on these six people and developed a non-invasive device for monitoring their health through the intestine, the stomach. If they had indigestion or gastric emptying problems, they had a different biorhythm. This was the concept, create a kind of portable clinic, which is how it will be in space, where an illness must be diagnosed in real time. To do so, you must have a device that can determine the substance and indicate the disease, so we know what course of action is to be taken.
Abbiamo sviluppato un dispositivo che è stato utilizzato sulla Stazione Spaziale Internazionale per la rivelazione del cortisolo, un ormone presente in saliva.
We developed a device used at the International Space Station for detecting cortisol, a hormone found in saliva that can be connected to some diseases. In particular, we used a very simple technique, lateral flow immunoassay, whose most well-known application is the pregnancy test. We adapted this technique for detecting our target analyte, cortisol, developing a portable device in which a saliva sample is injected. Through a series of very simple manual actions, like pushing buttons or opening and closing valves, the device can provide a complete analysis. We also use this technique in conjunction with chemiluminescence detection, a highly sensitive chemical reaction that can detect an analyte even in very small quantities. This emits light that can be captured in an image with very simple technology and then processed.
Quando ero negli Stati Uniti ho lavorato in un gruppo che si occupava di biochemiluminescenza, cioè di quel fenomeno.
When I was in the United States, I worked in a group studying bio and chemiluminescence, the phenomena of light emission caused by a chemical process. From a chemical process of A plus B, we get a product C, which emits light. If we measure a single photon, which is emitted, with an instrument that can be made, we can see a single molecule. If we optimize the whole process, developing technology capable of measuring a few photons with little light, we end up with an instrument that can measure small quantities of molecules in a biological fluid.
Potrebbero essere proprio utilizzati anche come rivelatori per determinati biosensori, in modo tale...
They could be used as detectors for specific biosensors, since in addition to being very easy to use and widely available, these instruments also allow us to get online and share a result with an expert who can provide a real-time treatment or instructions to follow.
L'Università di Bologna mi ha sempre dato la possibilità di crescere.
The University of Bologna has given me the opportunity to grow because it is a university with so many outstanding experts. I've been able to exchange ideas not just with chemists, but also with biochemists, doctors, molecular biologists, and virologists. This type of collaboration in an important university, where so much expertise abounds, created a synergy that could only happen in Bologna.
Per lavorare in campo scientifico, una delle qualità più importanti è la curiosità, la voglia di scoprire, la voglia di imparare cose nuove.
One of the most important qualities for work in the scientific field is curiosity, the desire to discover and learn new things. We're currently working on a research project regarding space exploration. In particular, we are working on developing analytical devices for detecting molecules on other celestial bodies that could be connected to the presence of current or past simple forms of life.
Futuro. Saremo bionici. Avremo tutti I sensori.
In the future, we will be bionic. We will all have sensors that tell us, today you have to eat less because you're overweight, because you have high cholesterol, or your liver is fatty. A metabolic checkup that tells us everything about our genome, about our entire history. We will talk about precision medicine, and we will provide precision chemistry for precision medicine.